Yes. It's still.
But you can't be any geek off the street. Gotta be handy with the steel, if you know what I mean.
Keeping it real.
Hello, and welcome back to the channel. My name is Steven, and this is Steel Keeping It Real. So you know what today is.
It's Friday, gotta get down on Friday.
That's right, it's Friday. And this week on Friday, what I'm doing is I'm doing early 80s hip-hop. But they're really, really obscure, only because they might have been popular in your area, in like big cities like New York, Chicago, Atlanta, Colorado, Denver, LA, but they weren't really national or nationwide. And this group I've been wanting to put on this channel for a long, long time, and this is the Kartoon Krew, and the song is called Batman. Now, this song came out in 1986, and I always thought that any one of the Batmans that have come out since this song came out should have used this song. Even though I do know they would have to take out the original samples in here of the first Batman television show, but they could have updated it, you know, but at least use this as a reference. And you'll hear why. And that's all I really have to say about it. I love this song. So, if you're still here, please don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe button, and the notification button, because I'm doing at least 15 videos each and every week. So, without any further ado, let's get into the Kartoon Krew and Batman.
And here we go.
Ready to move out.
joke's on you, Riddler. The joke's on you, Riddler. Joke's on you, Riddler.
All right, so that was Batman by the Kartoon Krew. Now, they also have, and I can't find much information on the Kartoon Krew, and of course we didn't have Google or any type of search engines. Nobody really had a computer. You had to be rich to have a computer in your home. And I lived in a middle-class neighborhood when this song came out, and it wasn't a necessity to have a computer. It would have been an expense, especially the computers of that day. It would have been an expense that nobody used. It would have sat there gathering dust. But what I did find out is that they had a song that stayed in the UK top 75 for 6 weeks. I don't think it's this one. I think it's the other one that they did that was really popular, and that's Inspector Gadget. That one's got great samples. But that beat is so hard driving. It sounds like something the Art of Noise would have done, like with beatbox. And maybe a little, what was the other one I had? Oh, Rockbox with Run-DMC. It sounded like those two married each other and then had a child, and that's this. Which is not a bad baby, I think. But, you know, it's a beat that gets you on the dance floor, and back in this day, it would have you breaking. It would have you, you know, pop and locking it. No, you can't see that. It is what it is these days. I'm 52. I was doing that stuff back when I was 13, 14 years old. And then I stopped doing it when the 90s hit. It was like, got rid of the jerry curl and stopped, you know, popping and locking. Stopped doing that stuff. So, good times, good times. So, if you're still here, I thank you for staying tuned. I really do appreciate it. I'm still on my goal to 1,000. I think I checked and I'm at 976. And it's like, I'm getting so close. Just 24 more subs and I've hit my goal of 1,000. And I'll be really, really happy. And then I think I will work on taking this channel and going into a new phase. Because I believe once I hit 1,000, I can get monetized. Right now, even if I didn't have copyright claims on my videos, which most of them do, once I hit 1,000, then I can get part of another program where certain restrictions might be lifted, and then I can get monetized. So that's why my goal is 1,000. Things change. So all you have to do to help me out is to like, subscribe, share, and comment. Peace.